So it's been said that we are now past the midpoint of summer, the middle of July. And I know for some of you that's exciting because you're looking forward to a fall activity or sport or getting ready for school again. But for a lot of you, that's like, oh, summer's half over. I've got so much going on or so much to do. I know for myself, I'm going to enjoy the next couple of weeks. I'm actually leaving this afternoon to go up canoeing in the Canadian Boundary Waters, as I do every year. And then from there, I'm actually going over to Lake of the Woods for a retreat on this island in Lake of the Woods. So I'm going to come back refreshed, hopefully, at the end of July. But for a lot of you, when you think of all the things you want to get done, and you got to do this, you got to do the garden, you got to do this, you got to do this, it's like, you get frantic. Well, let me show you how you can kind of deal with all the things you've got to do. I need a couple of volunteers, some older volunteers, maybe some teenagers or some adults. This is something tricky. So who feels brave? See if you can raise it up a little bit. And down again. Whoa! Hold it even above the hands. Do not try this at home. These are experts up here. You see, when you look at all the things we have going on, the things you have going on for the summer, it's really all about balance. It's how we can stay in balance. Now, as you've heard me say before, but let me repeat it, there are three things that I strive for every day to keep myself in balance. Good sleep, good exercise, good prayer. Sleep, exercise, prayer. I try for those every day. Don't always get to it. And sometimes I'll be hurried or something, I can't do very well. But I know that when I get those in place, then I can pretty well handle any obstacle or any challenge. For example, let's say I've got a busy day and I can't quite get to the exercise, so what I'll do is get in some kind of exercise. Like in the morning, I'll do some crunches or do some push-ups, just to do something. I might not get to the gym. Or with prayer time, maybe I don't have a long time to pray that day, but I will at least connect with God. Just to slow down and take some quiet time. And every day when I can do those three or strive for, then I feel better. If one's missing, no one really notices. If two or three are missing, then a lot of people notice, especially my staff. And they say, you're just not yourself today. Well, the whole idea for us as following Christ is to be balanced. Did you catch that theme all through the readings? In the first reading from Genesis, Abraham shows this balance of being hospitable. These strangers come. He could be afraid of them, but instead he is hospitable to them. He said, come in. Come into my area. Let me feed you. Now, as I said, they are angels. They are messengers of God. From his hospitality, then they reward him by having Sarah and him get pregnant. Now, remember, they're in their 80s. And so Sarah is actually eavesdropping to this conversation. And when she hears that, it's the verses right after we heard, she starts laughing. Me pregnant? I'm 80 years old. Are you kidding me? Well, she does get pregnant. And the name of her kid is Isaac. Remember, it's Abraham and Isaac. Remember, he's going to sacrifice Isaac. Well, Isaac means she laughed. So the fact of saying Sarah laughed is what got his name. Or in the gospel readings you heard, the famous story of Martha and Mary. Now, I've got to imagine that Martha is just trying to be hospitable herself. Got to do this, got to get that done. And maybe she's also a little bit of a workaholic because she has to get everything perfect. It has to be wonderful. It has to be the best kind of presentation she can for Jesus. But it's a whole idea, not that so much that Martha is only in the good or that Martha or Mary, but it's a balance. It's like the story of a man who goes to visit a monastery on Mount Sinai, which is in the Middle East. The man comes to the monastery, and he notices that the monks are out in the garden, and it's hot out, and they're laboring in the garden, toiling the earth. And he comes forward, and he talks to the abbot, and said, oh, don't your monks know that they should not labor for that which perishes? Remember the story of Martha and Mary. Mary chose the better portion. The abbot says, well, welcome to our monastery. He has one of the monks show him to his room and says, and give that man a good book to read. So the man gets settled in his room, spends the day there, is enjoying the book, he's out of the hot sun. But as the day goes on, it's getting later, he's noticing that nobody has called him for supper. And he's getting a little hungry. He stays in his room, and then all of a sudden the sun starts to set, and still he's getting really, really hungry. So he comes forth and he finds the abbot and he says, no one called me for supper, but don't you monks eat? The abbot said, well, of course we eat, but you are a spiritual person, obviously. So you do not need this kind of food. But since we are earthly, we want to eat. That's why we work. Instead, you have chosen the good part. Reading all day, wanting to eat this heavenly food. Well, the man said, forgive me. And the abbot said, yes. Mary needed Martha in order to sit and receive the words of Jesus. Paul gets that through all his writings. When we look at our lives, it's all about balance. Again, how to be open to God. And it's all things, keeping things in moderation. For example, some of you have always said, like, well, I want to lose some weight. And so what happens is you'll go on this drastic diet, or you do this huge big change in your life. And you know, it never really lasts. It doesn't work, as opposed to being balanced and just eating less or eating a little bit. Like, you've heard me say that exercise is important to me, and I am a runner, but I never run real strenuous. I mean, I'm never putting my body through a huge workout because I want to keep running until I'm 90 years old. There are people who are great athletes, but they put their bodies through a lot, so their knees are bad, their hips are bad. It's all about Then Jesus simply says, put things in perspective and then don't worry. Now, in another part of the scriptures, Jesus says, consider the lilies of the field. Consider the birds of the air. They don't worry. That's a great point. But you've got to remember, those birds, they don't just sit there and a worm just automatically appears on their beak. They have to go do their part. And then they simply let go. It's the same for all of us. Whatever we have going in our lives, it's doing our part, and basically it's getting ourselves in balance and then letting go. Now, as you heard me say, those three things that I need, sleep, exercise, prayer. Well, here's your challenge. I invite you to come up with your own points of balance that you need to work on every day. So you can't say, well, every day I need to fly to Disneyland. You can't say that, no. But what realistically do you need? You can copy mine if you want. Sleep, exercise, prayer. But maybe something like, well, I need to be in nature every day. Or I need to touch base with my family every day, or whatever it is. But it's the whole idea of attending to your points of balance. And then when there's that big thing coming up, you know, some of you got that big project at work, or you've got that big event that you're going to host, or you've got this big concern, what then we're invited to do is to be like Mary and let go. And simply trust God. We put in our work, we do what we need to do, like Martha, and then trust that God will be there. Sit at the feet of Jesus. Whatever it is you're freaking out about, you're worried about.